السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
الحمد لله، الحمد لله، ثم الحمد لله، الحمد لله كالذي نقول وخيرا مما نقول. يا ربنا لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك ومجدك، لك الحمد حتى ترضى، ولك الحمد إذا رضيت، ولك الحمد بعد الرضا. وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على حبيبنا وقائدنا وقرة أعيننا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، أحب الأحباب إلى رب الأرباب. يا رب صلي وسلم وزد وبارك عليه عدد ما أحاط به علمك، وخط به قلمك، وأحصاه كتابك. وارض اللهم عن ساداتنا أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي، وعن الصحابة أجمعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. معشر المسلمين، أوصيكم ونفسي المقصرة بتقوى الله، لقوله في كتابه: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. واعلموا أن شر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، كل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. My dear brothers and sisters, on these blessed days, it's important for us to remember a great event that has allowed us to emerge from the darkness into light. Not only ourselves, but countless generations before us. That event is the birth of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Today, I will not discuss the rulings in terms of celebrating his birthday. Rather, I'm gonna shed light on his miraculous birth, his upbringing, and his beautiful character that has been an example for all of us. Let us go back 16 centuries to the year of 571 AD إلى السنة 571 ميلادية. That was the year in which the king of Ethiopia, Al-Habasha, at that time, raided Mecca with an army led by the elephants, intending to destroy the Kaaba. Despite their plans, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protected his house by destroying those who attacked. That was the same year in which our beloved Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was born. The noble lineage of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, my dear brothers and sisters, was established long before his birth. The Prophet's lineage can be tracked back to Ibrahim alayhi salam, the father of all prophets, as narrated in Sunan al-Tirmidhi by Wathir ibn al-Asqa radiyallahu anhu, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Inna Allah astafa min waladi Ibrahima Ismail, wastafa min waladi Ismaila bani Kanana, wastafa min bani Kananata Quraysha, واصطفى من قريش بني هاشم واصطفاني من بني هاشم." Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen Ismail from the children of Ibrahim, and he chose Bani Kanana from the children of Ismail, and he chose the Quraysh from Bani Kanana, and he chose Bani Hashim from Quraysh, and he chose me from Bani Hashim. From this, we conclude that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has descended from 3,000 years of nobility, purity, and honor. وذلك مصداقا لحديث النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: خرجت من نكاح ولم أخرج من سفاح من لدن آدم إلى أن ولدني أبي وأمي لم يصبني من سفاح الجاهلية شيء. The entire universe, my dear brothers and sisters, was enlightened by the Prophet's arrival. Ever since the moment he was conceived in his mother's womb, as narrated in authentic chain, that some companion asked the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, "Ya Rasulallah, akhbirna an nafsik. Tell us about yourself." Faqala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, "Ana da'watu Abi Ibrahim, wa bushra Ismail, wara'at ummi hina hamilat bi ka'annahu kharaja minha nur. أضاءت له قصور بصرى من أرض الشام." I'm the answer to the prayer of the father of Ibrahim alayhi salam, and the glad tidings of Isa. And when my mother became pregnant with me, she saw something as if a light came out of her and illuminated the places of Busra in the land of Syria. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to honor the day was born, which fell on Monday, by fasting that day. And when he was asked, "Why you are fasting the day of Monday?" he said, "ذَلِكَ يَوْمٌ وُلِدْتُ فِيهِ." Therefore, we understand that is sunnah to do more deeds on our birthdays, not to make cake. Okay? The cake is like on the side. But the main thing on your birthday is to do more deeds than we usually would on any ordinary day. My dear brothers and sisters, إن رسولنا صلى الله عليه وسلم قد تميز بصفات خلقية وخلقية. كلنا نعلم كم كان خلق النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم راقيا رفيعا، لكن القليل منا يعرف عن صفاته الخلقية، شكله، صورته، جسده، حركته، شعره. فهذه فرصة أن نعلم شيئا عن صفاته الخلقية، بالأخص الآن مع ما نشهده من إساءة لشخصه صلى الله عليه وسلم برسومات كاريكاتيرية في فرنسا وغيرها من البلدان بدعوى الحرية. Our messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was distinguished through his unprecedented morality and upright character. We all know of the Prophet's beautiful and just character, but how many of us can name even a few of his physical qualities? Now that we witness many countries such as France outwardly insult the Prophets sallallahu alayhi wa sallam through creating caricatures under the notion of freedom, and it's important that we take the time in order to ponder over the beautiful physical qualities that concludes the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So I'm going to share with you authentic hadith in Musnad Imam Ahmad, narrated by Ali bin Abi Talib radiyallahu anhu, describing the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He started by saying he was neither tall or short. ليس بالطويل ولا بالقصير. He had large head and big beard. ضخم الرأس واللحية. And thick hands and feet. شثن الكفين والقدمين. His face had a reddish color. مشرب وجهه بالحمرة. Or مشرب وجهه حمرة. He had a long thin line of hair from the top of his chest to his navel. طويل المسربة، وذلك إشارة إلى الشعر من أعلى الصدر إلى السرة. He had large joints. ضخم الكراديس، والكراديس هي المفاصل كالركبة. When he walked, he walked energetically as is walking down well. إذا مشى مشى تكفأ، إذا مشى تكفأ تكفؤا كأنما ينحط من صبب. I never saw anyone like him before or since. لم أرى قبله ولا بعده مثله صلى الله عليه وسلم. And in another authentic hadith in Sahih Muslim narrated by Anas reported, ما شممت عنبرا قط ولا مسكا ولا شيئا أطيب من ريح رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا مسست شيئا قط ديباجا ولا حريرا ألين مسا من رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. I never smelled musk as fragrant as the fragrance of the body of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And I never touched brocade or silk and found it as soft as the body of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It comes as no surprise that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam held a special place in the companions' hearts. Every feature of his, both internal and external, was revered by those around him. As in Sahih Muslim, narrated by Anas bin Malik radiallahu anhu, reported. Please keep your phone silent, so I would like to continue with my khutbah. As in Sahih Muslim, narrated by Anas bin Malik, reported, دخل علينا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال عندنا. قال يعني أخذ قيلولة. فعرق وجاءت أمي بقارورة فجعلت تسلت العرق فيها. يعني تجمع العرق. فاستيقظ النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال يا أم سليم ما هذا الذي تصنعين؟ قالت هذا عرقك نجعله في طيبنا وهو من أطيب الطيب. الله أكبر. صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to came to our house and there was perspiration upon his body. My mother brought a bottle and began to pour the sweat in that bottle. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam got up, he said, "What you are doing, ya Umma Sulaim?" Thereupon, she said, "That's your sweat, which we mix in our perfume, and it becomes the most fragrant perfume." Not only was the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam loved by the people around him, he was also loved by every single creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لم يكن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم محبوبا من الناس حوله فقط، إنما كان محبوبا من كل شيء خلقه الله سبحانه وتعالى. Even seemingly lifeless objects showed deep love and reverence for the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. As reported in Sahih al-Bukhari, narrated by Anas bin Malik, that he heard Jabir bin Abdullah رضي الله عنهما يقول كان مسجد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم مسقوفا على جذوع من نخل. يعني يستند على جذوع من نخل. فكان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا خطب يقوم على جذع منها. فلما صنع له المنبر وكان عليه ذات يوم سمعنا لذلك الجذع صوتا كصوت العشار، والعشار هي الناقة الحامل، حتى جاء النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فوضع يده عليها فسكنت. الله أكبر. The roof of the mosque of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was built over trunks of date palms working as pillars. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam delivered his khutbah, he used to stand by one of those trunks till the pulpit was made for him. He used it instead. Then we heard the trunk sending a sound like of a pregnant she camel till the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came to it and put his hand over it. Then it became quiet. So if lifeless tree trunk longed for the presence of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what does that say about us? Do we long for the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Do we honor his legacy? Do we remember him by sending peace and blessing upon him? هل نتوق إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم؟ هل نذكره في صلواتنا وتسليماتنا عليه؟ في حلنا وترحالنا؟ Although we are not blessed by the ability to be physically near the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, we have the choice to carry him and his example with us everywhere we go. Being a Muslim, my dear brothers and sisters, being Muslim means placing the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger over everything, even our own selves. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى أكون أحب إليه من ولده ووالده والناس أجمعين. A proof of our love to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is to follow his sunnah and guidance. قل إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني يحببكم الله. Another proof of our love is to defend him and his sunnah, and to دافع عنه وعن سنته. The companion gave the most wonderful examples of defending the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And I want to share with you one of these examples. On the day of Uhud, many people were defeated and disappointed, and therefore left the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But Abu Talha radiyallahu anhu stood before him, covering him with a shield. Abu Talha radiyallahu anhu was a powerful archer who broke two or three bows that day. Whenever the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam raised his hand to look at the people, Abu Talha would say, Ya Nabi Allah, bi abi anta wa ummi, la tushrif, la yusibuka sahmun min siham al-qawm, nahri duna nahrik. Abu Talha addressing Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam at that moment, Ya Rasulallah, may my father and my mother be thy ransom. Don't raise your head lest you be struck by an arrow shot by the enemy. My neck is before your neck, Ya Rasulallah. As a result of the companion's dedication to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he honored them and rejoiced in them, as in Sahih al-Bukhari narrated by Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَا تَسُبُّوا أَصْحَابِي فَلَوْ أَنَّ أَحَدَكُمْ أَنْفَقَ مِثْلَ أُحُدٍ ذَهَبَ لَمْ يَبْلُغْ مُدَّ أَحَدِهِمْ وَلَا نَصِيفَةً. Don't abuse my companions, for if any one of you spend gold equal to Uhud mountain, it would not be equal to a mud or even half spent by one of them. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فيا فوز المستغفرين استغفر. الحمد لله وكفى صلاة والسلام على رسوله الذي اصطفى محمد خير الورى. معشر المسلمين, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, If we truly love and are dedicated to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we must follow his teachings and defend him. As we hope he will do the same for us on the day where there will be no one to intercede on our behalf except for him. لن يكون لنا شفيعا إلا هو صلى الله عليه وسلم. However, we can't do that unless we take the time to learn about the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and understand the authentic hadith of Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. So I encourage you and your families to dedicate a single day of the week in which you set time aside to learn about and come closer to Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. معشر المسلمين, my dear brothers and sisters, among the things proves you are a defender of Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم is that you are against everyone who is hostile to the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم. One of the tools that we should use now is to boycott the products of that country that the hostility is coming from. And it's the minimum thing as Muslim that we can do. إن من أقل الأمور وكما يسمى جهد المقل أن نقاطع كل من يعادي رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. وهذا شيء قليل نقدمه في نصرته صلى الله عليه وسلم. وكما قال الإمام ابن تيمية, لا يوالى أحد ولا يعادى على شيء إلا شخص رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Finally, I would like to remind myself and all of you to spend prayers and blessings upon the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, especially in this day. And if you would like to be revealed of all of your worries and sins, then devote yourself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger. And you know the story when one of the companions came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and asked him, كَمْ أَجْعَلُ لَكَ مِنْ صَلَاتِي. Then the conclusion, I will devote myself to make salah and salam upon you. So what is the reward from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam? He said, إِذَنْ تُكْفَى هَمَّكْ وَيُغْفَرُ لَكَ ذَنْبُكْ. وَاعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ صَلَّى عَلَى نَبِيُّكُمْ قَدِيمًا وَلَمْ يَزَلْ قَائِلًا عَلِيمًا حَكِيمًا. إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. لَبَّيْكَ اللَّهُمَّ صَلِّ عَلَى مُحَمَّدٍ وَعَلَى آلِ مُحَمَّدٍ كَمَا صَلَّيْتَ عَلَى إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَعَلَى آلِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ إِنَّكَ حَمِيدٌ مَجِيدٌ. اللَّهُمَّ بَارِكْ عَلَى مُحَمَّدٍ وَعَلَى آلِ مُحَمَّدٍ كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم صل الإسلام وأعز المسلمين وأعلي بفضلك وكلمتك راية الحق والدين. اللهم أرنا الإسلام عزيزا يا عزيز. اللهم اجعل اجتماعنا هذا اجتماعا مرحوما, واجعل تفرقنا من بعده تفرقا معصوما, ولا تجعل فينا ولا بيننا شقيا ولا محروما. اللهم ارحمنا فإنك بنا راحم, ولا تعذبنا فإنك على عذابنا قادر, والطف بنا فيما جرت به المقادير, ودبر لنا يا مولانا فإنا لا نحسن التدبير. اللهم إن جهدنا جهد المقل في نصرة حبيبنا وسيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم, وأنت خير الناصرين. اللهم فانصره وأيده بمدد من عندك يا الله يا رحمن يا رحيم, وأعنا على نصرته بوسع طاقتنا وقدرتنا، فإنك على كل شيء قدير. اللهم اغفر لنا ولآبائنا وأمهاتنا، ارحمهم كما ربونا صغارا، وارزقنا برهم أحياء وأمواتا، آمين يا رب العالمين. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأقم الصلاة.